Hello everyone, this is Preeti, working as Assistant Professor in Department of Civil Engineering in Karpagam Academy of Higher Education, Coimbatore. This video lecture is about concrete technology, which contains 8 video lectures and each will take 10 to 15 minutes. Topics to be discussed in the lecture series are, in lecture 1, we are going to see about the cement production, composition and properties. In lecture 2, we are going to see about aggregate and its property and testers, part 1. In lecture 3, we are going to see about aggregate and its property and testers, part 2. In lecture 4, we are going to see about admixtures in concrete. In lecture 5, we are going to see about concrete mix design. In lecture 6, we are going to see about properties of fresh concrete. In lecture 7, we are going to see about properties of hardened concrete. In lecture 8, we are going to see about special concrete. Today, we are going to discuss about what is meant by cement, how it is produced, their composition and production. Before we going to discuss it, we have to know what is meant by concrete. Concrete's versatility, sustainability, durability and economy have made it the world's most widely used construction material. About 4 tons of concrete are produced by person per year in worldwide. The term concrete refers to a mixture of aggregate, usually sand and gravel or crushed stone, held it together with a cementing paste. The paste, which is made up of cement and water and may also contain supplementary cementitious material such as fly ash or slag or chemical admix. Composition of concrete. Typically, a mix is about 10-15% of cement, 60-75% of aggregate and 15-20% of water. In some concrete mixes, entrapped air may also take place, 5-8%. Let us start with the cement. Cement is the basic ingredient of concrete and it is widely used as construction material in worldwide. It is a very critical ingredient because only cement has the property of enhancing the viscosity of concrete and providing better locking of sand and gravel together in a cementitious mix. In concrete, cement and water acted as a active material and fine aggregate and coarse aggregate acted as a inactive material because it does not take place any chemical reactions like cement and water. Let's see about how cement is made. By using the calcareous material such as limestone or chalk and argillaceous material such as shale or clay, blast furnace ash, silica sand, iron ore and gypsum used as a raw material. It has 6 phases to complete the manufacturing process of cement. In first phase, extraction of raw material. In second phase, blending, grinding and proportioning. In third phase, preheater kiln. In fourth phase, kiln phase. In fifth phase, cooling and grinding. In sixth phase, packing and shipping. In initial stage, both raw materials are finely mixed and grounded. The raw material is preheated before it is going into the kiln. It burns at 1500 degrees Celsius. The raw mix is heated to produce the clinker. In next stage, the clinker, which is mixed with gypsum and it is grounded into a fine powder, which is called as pure cement. We can also some cementitious material to produce the blended cement. The cement is stored in silos before going to dispatch. Next, chemical composition of cement. During the burning process, the raw materials are fused together and produced more complex chemical compositions such as lime, silica, alumina, magnesia, iron oxide, sulfates, loss of ignition, insoluble residues, lime saturation factor. Lime controls strength and soundness. Silica provides strength. Alumina responsible for quick setting. Iron oxides gives color and helps in fusion with different cement ingredients. Magnesium gives color and hardness. A small amount of sulfur which is used to make cement sound. Next one, Boax compound. When water is added to the cement, the major compounds are developed. The identification of major compounds is based on the R.H. Boax research work. Hence, it is called as Boax compound. These Boax compound are tricalcium silicate, dicalcium silicate, tricalcium aluminate, tetracalcium aluminoferrate. Next one, hydration of cement. When water is added to the cement, the ingredients of cement react chemically with water and forms various complicated chemical compounds. That is called hydration of cement. During this hydration process, the cement produced calcium hydrate silicate, which is denoted as CHS, and calcium hydrate aluminate, which is denoted as CHA. These products are thick and sticky, is said to be CHS or CHA gel. Next one, properties of cement, which is differentiated into physical properties and chemical properties. In physical properties, it contains fineness, soundness, setting time, strength and consistency. In chemical properties, which has ratio of percentage of alumina to iron oxide, lime saturation factor, loss of ignition and then weight of magnesia, sulfur content, etc. In chemical properties, the ratio of percentage of alumina to iron oxide should not be less than 0.66%. And the next one, the ratio of percentage of lime to alumina, iron oxide and silica, which is known as lime saturation factor, which is denoted as LSH. It should be less than 0.66% and not more than 1.05%. Total loss of ignition should not more than 4% and total loss of sulfur content should not more than 2.75%. Weight of insoluble residue should not more than 1.50%. Weight of magnesia should not exceed 5%. In physical properties, a thin paste of cement with water should feel sticky between the fingers. And the next one, a cement is thrown in water should sink and should not be floated on the surfaces. A particle should have uniformity of fineness. To get an idea of fineness, specific surface area is measured. The specific surface area is a measure of the frequency of particle of average sizes, which should not be less than 2250 cm² per gram. The consistency of the cement should be verified with wicket apparatus. If the settlement of the plunger is between 5 mm to 7 mm from the bottom of the mold, the water added is correct. Otherwise, repeat the procedure with different percentage of water until the desired penetration is achieved. The initial setting time of cement is 30 minutes. The initial setting time is the interval between the addition of water and the stage when the square needle of wicket apparatus ceases to penetrate completely. The final setting time of cement is 10 hours. The final setting time of cement is the difference between the time at which the addition of water and the time required to annular collar needle ceases to penetrate and make an impression on the test blocks. The soundness of cement should be checked with the Leach Atelier apparatus. This test, which is used to detect the presence of uncombined lime in cement. The expansion of cement after heating and cooling of molds should not be exceed 10 mm. Next, compressive strength. The compressive strength at the end of 3 days should not be less than 11.5 Newton per mm square. At the end of 7 days should not be less than 17.5 Newton per mm square. And then next one, tensile strength. The tensile strength at the end of 3 days should not be less than 2 Newton per mm square. At the end of 7 days should not be less than 2.5 Newton per mm square. Let's come to an end of the session. I hope you all understand about the cement and its production, composition and properties. In upcoming lecture, we are going to see about aggregate and its property and testers. Thank you.